Okay, in last lecture we have seen designing of low pass filter using Chebyshev filter and also with Butterworth filter. Now if we want to design a high pass or a band pass or a band stop filter, then we have to do frequency transformations, and that is our today's topic. In this process we have to simply transform the frequency of prototype filter, where this prototype filter is the designed low pass filter using Chebyshev or Butterworth filter. Now there are two kinds of frequency transformation, one in analog domain and other is at digital domain. So we will start at a stage 1 prototype low pass filter. After this we can move towards stage 2. We can have two approaches to go towards stage 2. The first one is transform to other frequencies. That means in this stage we will transform from low pass to high pass or low pass to band pass. In second approach we will transform this low pass filter to equivalent digital filter. Then after we have stage 3. In this stage, the first approach we will convert to corresponding digital filter by mapping from S to Z. In second approach, we will transform to desired digital filter by digital transformation. The first approach is called frequency transformation in analog domain. Second one is called frequency transformation in digital domain. In general, the results obtained from analog domain or digital domain are not same except for the case of bilinear transformation. Now after characterizing the frequency transformations, we will start with analog domain frequency transformation. So we will discuss in part 1 low pass to low pass filter transformation. Say prototype filter has pass band edge frequency omega p and the desired filter has pass band edge frequency at omega p dash. Then by the definition of Chebyshev filter we know square is equal to 1 over 1 plus E square Tn square omega over omega p. Now for S is equal to j omega h omega square, for omega is equal to S by j will be equal to 1 over 1 plus E square Tn square S by j omega. Now shifting pass band edge frequency to omega p dash requires that this omega p dash should replace this omega p, right? So this can be happen if we substitute S to omega p by omega p dash into S. If we substitute S transformation as this, then h of omega square at omega is equal to S by j will be equal to 1 over 1 plus E square Tn square omega p S over omega p dash with j. Now this omega p and this omega p cancelled out, so it will be 1 over 1 plus E square Tn square S by j omega p dash. So now the passband edge frequency of this low pass filter is shifted to omega p dash. Omega p dash from omega p, and this is the first kind of transformation from low pass to low pass. Second one is low pass filter to high pass filter transformation. Before starting this point, we'll first plot how a low pass filter will look like and how high pass filter's response looks like. So if it is H omega square, this one is low pass response and this response is for the high pass filter. So this one is omega p dash and this is omega s dash. So we want this transformation to happen. Now we know this is h omega mod square equals to 1 over 1 plus e square en omega by omega p, right? We know as tn x for x equals to 0, tn 0 is 1 or 0 depending upon value of n, odd or even, right? So we are just talking about this tn x. Then tn x for x tending to infinity, that is tn infinity, is infinity. Now what does it mean? As this tn tends to infinity, this h omega tends to 0. One can see for higher frequency, the response of the filter is going towards 0. So what happens if this omega over omega p changes the direction? So for high pass filter, it should look like h omega square will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square tn omega p by omega. Then this function will act for high pass filter. And for this particular case, it should be omega p dash. Now we want to see for what transformation case this function will turn out to be this. Now we know mod of h omega square can be written in terms of omega equals to s by j 1 plus e square tn s by j omega p. Now if we substitute, we want to form a term like this. So if we take the transformation from s to omega p dash by s, it will give 1 over 1 plus e square tn omega p dash over j omega p. This omega p cancelled out, so it is h omega square omega is equal to s by j. Then it is 1 over 1 plus e square tn omega p dash by js, which is the necessary transformation required for high pass filter. Now third case is low pass filter to band pass filter. The response of band pass filter should be like, now omega naught square is omega l into omega u and the bandwidth is w is omega u minus omega l. Now we can achieve this kind of transformation using the knowledge of low pass filter and high pass filter. We can make a low pass filter with transformation omega p omega naught s. That low pass filter will have pass band h frequency at omega naught, and a high pass filter omega p with omega naught by s. This will have a response like this with the pass band h frequency at omega naught. Now if we add these two responses, it will give a response like maximum at peak omega naught and then like this. So it is at maximum at omega naught. So addition of this and this will give a response like this. Now what does it mean? It is omega p by omega naught s plus omega p omega naught s by s will be equal to omega p s square plus omega p omega naught square over omega naught. Now this transformation is not yet band pass, as the information of band w equals to omega u minus omega l is missing. So if we make s transform as s as omega naught by w with omega p s square plus omega p omega naught square over omega naught s will give s as omega p s square plus omega naught square by w s, or written as omega p s square plus omega u into omega l over omega u minus omega l into s. Now if you substitute, this into h omega square for omega is equal to s by j will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square pn square omega p s square plus omega u omega l over omega p j omega p then omega u minus omega l into s. So this omega p cancelled out. So we left with 1 over 1 plus e square pn square s square plus omega u omega l j omega u minus omega l. Now if you want to verify this function for a band pass filter, we'll check first at omega equals to 0. So for that we'll convert this s is equal to j omega. So then h omega square will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square pn square minus omega square plus omega u into omega l over j omega u minus omega l. J will be gone and it will be with a negative sign omega. Now putting omega is equal to 0 will get h 0 square equals to 1 over 1 plus e square pn square. This will be omega u omega l by 0. Now as pn is infinity, it will go to infinity. So this h 0 mod square will be equal to 0. Now second case is we'll put omega is equal to infinity, then h of infinity square will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square tn infinity by infinity. Now L'Hospital rule mod of h infinity square will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square tn will be minus 2 omega over omega u minus omega l. Substituting this it will give 1 over 1 plus e square tn infinity. It will go to infinity leading to h infinity is equal to 0. It has a point, it can be a band pass filter. Now we have to check third at omega is equal to omega l, then h of omega l square will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square tn square minus omega l square plus omega l into omega u omega l omega u minus omega l. If we solve this we'll get 1 over 1 plus e square pn square. So it is omega l minus omega l plus omega u over minus omega l, which will be cancelled out. So it will be over 1 plus e square pn square 1. Tn square 1 is for the pass band edge frequency, which is equal to 1 over 1 plus e square. Then h of omega l will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square as. Now for final case, that is omega is equal to omega u, then h of omega u l will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square pn square. This is minus of omega u square plus omega u omega l over minus omega u minus omega l. This will be equal to 1 over 1 plus e square pn square, same omega u will cancel out, so it is minus omega u plus omega l, that is omega u minus omega l, leading to 1 over 1 plus e square pn square minus 1. Please note that tn is a function of cosine, so it is an even function. Also there is a square term also, so this entire h omega u square will be equal to 1 plus e square, which is the magnitude response at passband edge frequency. So the results we have find out for the transformation case in band pass is s can be transformed into omega p s square plus omega naught square over w. Now fourth point after this is low pass filter to band stop filter. We know band stop filter is opposite of band pass filter. That's mean if s is substituted as omega p, ws over s square plus omega naught square that will work as a transformation for band stop filter. Then we can summarize all the results as type of transformation, transformation and band edge frequency. So first one is low pass transformation is s to omega p by omega p dash s, here this is omega p dash. Then for high pass s to omega p dash by s, passband edge frequency in this case is omega p dash. For band pass s is omega p s square plus omega l into omega u or omega naught square, we will write omega l by omega u, omega l by omega u, then s omega u minus omega, in this case passband edge frequencies are omega l and omega u which we have seen. Then band stop s is omega p s omega u minus omega l over s square plus omega l into omega l. In this case also omega l and omega u are the band edge. With this we have completed the frequency transformation in analog domain. That's all for this lecture. Thank you.